What's up, everyone? My name is Jay Walker, and today I'm going to be demonstrating a way you can set up a free VPN using a service called FrootVPN. The reason why some people use VPNs is to bypass block services, or to anonymize themselves online, or even to encrypt their traffic if they're in a coffee shop or some public place, like an airport. To show you an example of a block service here in the United States, I'm going to navigate to hbonordic.com. And as you can see here, HBO Nordic is only available in Sweden, Finland, Denmark, and Norway, so I can't access it here from the United States. Well, if somebody doesn't want to follow the rules, they can just go to fruitvpn.com. Their servers are located in Sweden, so all we have to do is create an account there, and basically our IP address will make it seem like we are in Sweden and not the United States. So let's go ahead and create a new account at fruitvpn.com. And once you're done with the registration process, go ahead and click on Get Started. You should receive an email confirmation within the next few minutes. Go ahead and pause the video if you're still waiting for your email confirmation, and just come back to the video once you received it. Okay, if you pause the video, welcome back. Now let's go down to your Start menu and right-click on it and access your Control Panel. Under Network and Internet, click on View Network Status and Tasks. Set up a new connection or network, and connect to a workplace. How do you want to connect? Use my internet connection VPN. Under internet address, just follow my lead and type in what I'm about to type. And the destination name really doesn't matter, so just type in something that identifies your VPN. And once you're done with this, just go ahead and click on Create, and we'll get ready for the last step. Finally, we need to configure your VPN's connection type. And to do this, we'll need to go to Change Adapter Settings, right-click on FrootVPN, and go to Properties. Click on the Security tab, and under Type of VPN, select PPTP, Point-to-Point Telemetry Protocol, and under Data Encryption, select Maximum Strength Encryption, and click on OK. Now you can connect to the VPN using these settings, but if you're security conscious and you want to use a layer 2 tunneling protocol connection, just go ahead and right click on Properties. And under Security, under the type of VPN, select Layer 2 Tunneling Protocol, L2TP. And under Advanced Settings, you want to use the pre-shared key that I'm entering right here. This is going to be specifically for the server, so it's not your actual password or your pre-shared key. Click on OK. And under Data Encryption, change that to Maximum Strength Encryption. And once you're done, just go ahead and click on OK. And that was the final step. Now all we need to do is test the connection. Just right-click on FrootVPN and connect. And from here, enter the username and password that you entered at FrootVPN's registration page. All right, let's see if it works. And I'm connected. It's working great. And one of the most non-technical basic ways you can check to see if you're connected to the VPN is just checking your IP address. And in this case, I'm going to whatismyip.com. And you can see here that my IP address is no longer my ISP's IP address, but my VPN's IP address. I know you want to see the bypass in action, but I think YouTube will actually tear me a new one if I do it. All right, here you go. Thanks for watching.